WordPress Studio now supports blueprints, which lets you create local sites from repeatable recipes. Now, these blueprints can include everything from your preferred WordPress version, your favorite plugins, your theme, and they also can do complicated things like run PHP and run WPCLI commands. So there's a ton you can do with it. Now, Studio comes with a set of featured blueprints that you can just use and get going quickly, or you can use your own custom blueprints. So let's dive in and look at how blueprints work in Studio. All right, here we are in Studio, and you can see that I have one site running called Portfolio. To get started with blueprints, click on the Add Site button in the bottom left-hand corner, and you'll be presented with a new screen with three options: create a site, start from a blueprint, or import from a backup. Let's click on Start from a Blueprint. On the following screen, you're going to be presented with three options, featured blueprints that you can choose to start a local site. You can think of each of these like a recipe. Under the hood, blueprints are just a JSON file that describe how a site is built in WordPress Studio. This could include the preferred WordPress and PHP versions, which plugins and themes to install, as well as what content and settings to apply. The quick start option gives you a WordPress.com-like environment with a collection of plugins. And the development option, which is my favorite, is geared towards WordPress theme and plugin developers and includes utility plugins such as the Create Block Theme plugin and others like Plugin Check. And the commerce option is designed for those looking to build an online store with WooCommerce and comes with a collection of companion plugins pre-installed and ready to go. Now, if any of these feature blueprints sound interesting to you, you just simply click on one, click continue, and then you'll enter in the normal add a site flow where you can set the site name and configure advanced settings. But before we do that, let's go back and I want to show you my favorite feature of blueprints, and that is actually using your own custom blueprints. So as you become more familiar with blueprints and how they work, you'll probably want to start creating your own. Blueprints are all about improving your workflows. So if you find yourself creating the same local sites with the same plugins, the same theme, same site settings over and over again, consider turning that into a blueprint. Let's take a quick look at an example here. I have a sample blueprint, and this one's pretty basic, but if we take a look, we can see that it's doing a bunch of things. First, it's going to be setting the preferred WordPress and PHP versions. I'm also installing WooCommerce, so maybe I build a lot of WooCommerce sites. I'm also installing the pendant theme from the WordPress.org repo. Now, you can install plugins and themes from the WordPress.org repository or other places like GitHub, which is really handy, especially if you're a developer. Finally, we're going to be setting some user meta. Here, we're going to set the default admin color scheme to modern. This is something I always do whenever I start a new site, so it's nice to be able to handle that already inside of the blueprint. Now again, this is a really simple blueprint and you can do so much more, and I encourage you to check out the documentation for information on how to add additional steps to your blueprint. Now to use this blueprint, all you need to do is click the Choose Blueprint File button and you'll be able to select a blueprint from your computer. We'll select Sample Blueprint. There we go. And then again, just click Continue and you enter into the same Add a Site flow. We'll give it a name and we'll click Add Site. Now, whenever you create a site from a blueprint, whether it's one of the featured blueprints or your own, note that this process does take a little bit longer because Studio needs to download any plugins you specified, the theme, and set all those site settings. But here we go, the site is complete and we can head on over to the WordPress admin and we'll see that WooCommerce is installed, and then if we click on themes, we can see that the pendant theme is installed as well. And that's how easy it is to set up a local site with a blueprint in Studio. So if you're already a Studio user, just update to the latest version when prompted, and you'll have this new functionality. And if you're not a Studio user yet, and this video encourages you to try it out, head on over to WordPress.studio. where you can download the latest version for Mac or Windows. And if you found this content useful or interesting, consider liking and subscribing. And hopefully, I'll see you on future videos covering more of the features of WordPress Studio.